Reading from Bhagavad Gita, chapter 18, text number 46. यथा प्रवृत्तिर्भूतानं येन सर्वं इदं ततं स्वकर्मणा तम् अभ्याचार्य सिद्धिं विन्दति मानवा यथा प्रवृत्तिर्भूतानं येन सर्वमिदं ततं स्वकर्मणा तम् अभ्याचार्य सिद्धिं विन्दति मानवा यथा प्रवृत्तिर्भूतानं येन सर्वमिदं ततं स्वकर्मणा तम् अभ्याचार्य सिद्धिं विन्दति मानवा
यथा
प्रवृत्ति भूतनं येन सर्वं
इदं
ततं
स्वकर्मणा
通过自己的一个完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美完美
生之源变成泛有的自身主，人就可以通过履行自己的工作而达到完美境界。圣帕帕德要旨，正如第十五章所述，众生都是至尊主的碎片部分，因此至尊主是众生之始，这一点在终极伟达经有确证，一切都源于他。所以至尊主是每一个生物生命的原始。佛家梵歌第七章还说，至尊主以其两种能量，即内在能量和外在能量而变成万有，所以人应该崇拜具有能量的至尊主。一般来说，怀斯拉瓦路线者崇拜至尊主及其内在能量。主的外在能量是内在能量的颠倒反应，外在能量是一种背景，但至尊主却以超灵这一全权扩展部分而无所不在。它是所有半神人、所有人类、所有动物的超灵，无处不在。因此作为至尊主的所属碎片部分，人应该认识到有责任为至尊者服务。人人都应以完全的 Krishna 知觉从事对主的奉爱服务。这节诗倡导这种做法，每个人都该这样想。它是由感官之主 Rishikesh 安排而从事某种特别的职分的，因此应该把所从事的工作的结果用来崇拜至尊人的守神 Krishna。 如果能经常在完全的 Krishna 知觉中这样想问题，就会得到主的恩典，完全知觉一切，这就是生命的完美境界。主在《国家梵歌》第十二章第七十节中说，我拯救他们，至尊主亲自负责解救这样的奉献者，这就是生命最完美的境界。无论从事的是什么职业，只要服务于至尊主，必能达到最高的完美境界。
Om Jnana Timirantasya Jnanjana Shalakaya Chatur Militanyena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Shri Chaitanya Manobhisam Sapitanyena Bhutave Swayam Rupa Kadamaya
yam dadati svapadatika vanchakaupa tarudhyasya kripa sindhu vaivaca patitanam pavanebhyo vaishnavebhyo namo namaha Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhara Shiva Sadi Govardhana Vrinda Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare
Chapter 18. This is the summary of all the teachings which have been given in the other chapters.
第十八章呢，是对其他所有章节的一个总结。
So Lord Krishna had been describing the effect, the influence of the three modes of nature.
Krishna 描述了物质自然三属性的影响。
And he was describing how there are four different divisions of society.
而且他也描述了社会的四种不同的划分。There
is the intellectual class, the brahmana.
有充满有学识的阶层，即brahma阶层。
And then there is the managerial or administrators, the kshatriyas.
然后呢，有管理阶层，也就是kshatriya。
And then you have the mercantile or the business community, the vaishya.
然后呢，还有做生意的阶层，也就是vaishya。
And then you have the laborers or the sudra.
然后呢，就是劳工阶层，sudra.
So Lord Krishna described the qualities of each of these division, each of these people.
所以主 Krishna 就描述了这四个不同阶层的人所具有的不同品质.
And Lord Krishna then went on to say that everyone according to their qualities, they should work according to their nature.
Krishna 还说到呢，一个人应该根据自己的本性和品质来从事相应的活动。And
this is pleasing to Krishna.
如果一个人这样做的话呢，就能取悦Krishna.
So now Krishna is also saying, not only work, but you also have to worship Krishna.
而且 Krishna 也说到呢，你不仅仅应该去工作，而且应该来崇拜 Krishna.
We have to recognize that Krishna is the proprietor of everything.
我们应该知道，至尊主 Krishna 是所有万事万物的拥有者。Described
here that he is the source of all beings.
这里讲到，主 Krishna 是所有众生的源头。Everything
comes from him.
所有的一切都流眼于他。We
have heard this in many verses of the Bhagavad Gita.
我们在《博迦梵歌》当中的很多诗节都听到这一点。
Especially in the 10th chapter,
尤其是在第十章当中,
verse number
8, 第八个世界,
where Krishna says everything material and spiritual comes from him.
主 Krishna 说到一切物质的和灵性的都来源于他。
So he is the source of the material energy and the spiritual energy.
因此呢，他是物质能量和灵性能量的源头。
So he's all pervading, he's everywhere.
他变成万有，无处不在。
He's everywhere in his here in the material world, he's everywhere in the through the Paramatma feature.
他通过他的超灵的形式，在这个物质世界里变成万有。
Paramatma is in the heart of all the living entities.
超灵在每一个生物体的心中。
And it's also in the atoms.
也在原子当中。
So Krishna is everywhere and he's everything is coming from him. So therefore it's our duty to also respect him, to worship him.
因为 Krishna 无处不在，而且万事万物都流连于他，所以呢，我们要去崇拜他，去尊敬他，这是我们的责任。
And our work is done for his pleasure.
我们所从事的工作也是为了去取悦他。
Whatever we're doing, we do it under that this is given to us, this work is given to us by the arrangement of Krishna.
无论我们有什么样的工作，这些工作呢，都是通过主的安排来给予我们的。
We see that many different varieties of engagement.
我们看到人们都在从事不同的工作。
But everything is given to us through the arrangement of Krishna.
但是呢，所有这一切都是通过 Krishna 的安排来赐予我们的。
Prabhupada says, if we are always thinking in this way, then this is Krishna consciousness.
帕帕德说道，如果我们总是这样去想的话，这就是 Krishna 知觉。
And Krishna, when we surrender to Krishna and do what is given, the duties which are given to us by Krishna, then Krishna will deliver us.
如果我们向 Krishna 皈依，如果我们去从事这个 Krishna 给予我们的工作，这样的话 ，Krishna 就会来解救我们。
Whatever duty we're doing, if we do it for Krishna, then we can get perfection.
无论我们的职责是什么，如果我们是为 Krishna 去做的，我们就能够得到完美。
Krishna doesn't say, "Oh, he's only going to deliver the Brahmana."
Krishna 并没有说他只解救那些婆罗门。
The Brahmanas, of course, are very dear to Krishna.
当然了，婆罗门对 Krishna 非常亲切。
But the cows are also dear to Krishna.
但是母牛也对 Krishna 十分亲切。
All the devotees are dear to Krishna.
所有的奉献者都对 Krishna 十分亲切。
One may be a Brahmana and may not be a devotee, so then that is not very pleasing to Krishna.
一个人即便是 Brahmana， 但如果不是奉献者的话，这也不能够给 Krishna 带来很大的快乐。
We can give them respect because they are Brahmanas. We will offer respect to them.
我们可以尊敬他们，向他们致敬，因为他们是婆罗门。
But if they are not devotees of Krishna, then we are not very eager to hear from them or to associate with them.
但是呢，如果他们不是奉献者的话，我们就没有很大的兴趣去聆听他们的讲话和他们联谊。
There are many Brahmanas who are not devotees.
有很多的婆罗门都不是奉献者。
They're Brahmana only by birth.
他们只是因为出生在婆罗门的家庭。
And they often do not have the qualities of the Brahman.
但是呢，他们常常都不具备婆罗门的品质。
So Krishna is saying, we have to do our duty. We have to know what is our position.And then work according to that position.
Krishna 说到呢，我们应该从事我们的职责，我们应该了解我们所处的地位，然后根据我们所处的地位去工作，去活动。
And that way then we attract the mercy of Krishna. We attract Krishna's attention.
这样做的话，我们可以去吸引 Krishna 的仁慈。
Now that takes, of course, we have to surrender in order to do this.
当然了，为了达到这一点呢，我们需要向 Krishna 皈依。
We may think, oh, I don't like this job, I don't like this work, I want to do some other work.
也许我们会想，我不喜欢这份工作，我不喜欢这个活动，我想去做点别的。
But if we stay in our position and just do whatever service is given to us by Krishna, then that is pleasing to Krishna.
但是呢，如果我们只是留在我们所处的位置去做相应的活动的话，这样的话可以取悦 Krishna。
Just like in the Bhagavad Gita, Arjuna who did not want to fight the battle.
就比如说在《博迦梵歌》当中 ，Arjuna 不愿意作战。
But Arjuna was a Kshatriya. He was meant to fight.
但是 Arjuna 是一位查崔亚，作战是他的职责。
And he even come to the battlefield.
他甚至已经到了这个战场上，拿着这些武器。
But then he said, "No, I don't want to fight. I want to go. I'll just be a beggar."
但是他却说呢，我不想作战，我只要去乞讨就可以了。
But Krishna said, "This is not your nature. You should do what is your duty."
但是 Krishna 说呢，这不是你的本性，你应该去从事你的职责。
We have to understand clearly what is our prescribed duty, and then act in that way.
我们应该很清楚地知道我们的规定职责是什么，然后以相应的方式去活动。
That's what Krishna was describing in the principle society.
因此呢 ，Krishna 就描述了社会当中四个不同的阶层。
Right. There,
The intellectual class are like the head in the body.
这个有学识的阶层，婆罗门阶层就好比头部。
They're meant to guide and give instruction, direction.
他们是为了给予人们指导，给予人们训示和方向。
And the kshatriya, they're the managers. They tell people what to do. They give instructions.
这个kshatriya呀，就是管理阶层的话，他们需要告诉人们去做什么，如何去做。
You've got the vaishya, the good people doing business. They like to.Buy and sell, they're always thinking how to make money.
这个观想的阶层呢，他们总是在做生意，他们总是在想着怎么去赚钱。
And other people work, they work, they're told what to do. They don't think for themselves, they're told what to do.
然后其他的人呢，他们就是去从事这个劳工的活动，然后他们自己也并不去思考。别人让他做什么，他就去做什么。
So in the Kali Yuga, we are all sudra by birth.
在卡里年代，我们每一个人出生就是 sudra.
From the birth, we have that nature to be like the sudra.
从一出生开始呢，我们就具有这样的本性，就想要就要去像 sudra 一样去行事。
But in course of time, we begin to display different qualities.
但是随着时间的进展呢，我们开始展示出不同的品性。
Some people are inclined to study. They like to learn education.
有的人呢倾向于去学习，然后他们获得教育。
And they show more inclination. Their nature is more towards the brahmana work.
他们的本性呢，更倾向于去从事婆罗门的工作。
They're not so much interested in the material aspects of life. They're not much concerned about economic development.
他们对物质生活呢不是很感兴趣，他们对那个经济发展呢也没有什么兴趣。
So this Brahmana class, this is not noticed immediately. You cannot immediately from birth understand who is a Brahman.
所以对于这个婆罗门阶层的话，不能够通过一个人的出生去看。
But Brahmana qualities can be cultivated by proper training and association.
而是在这个联谊当中，通过恰当的训练，可以培养出这些婆罗门的品质。
The Krishna consciousness movement, however, is not only for Brahmanas, it's for everyone.
然而呢，昆士玛知觉运动不仅仅是给予婆罗门的，而是面向所有人的。
Krishna, Arjuna is not a Brahmana.
Arjuna 并不是一位婆罗门。
Arjuna is a Kshatriya.
Arjuna 是一位查崔亚。
But Krishna is speaking Bhagavad Gita to him.
但是呢，昆士玛向 Arjuna 讲述了国家梵歌。
The Krishna consciousness movement is therefore for everyone.To become devotee.
因此 ，Krishna 知觉运动是面向所有人的，让所有人都成为奉献者。
Everyone has Krishna in their heart.
每一个人的心中都有 Krishna.
So everyone has some Krishna consciousness.
所以每个人呢都有 Krishna 知觉。
That's why when we hear about Krishna, then we awaken our consciousness of Krishna.
所以当我们聆听 Krishna 的时候，我们的心中的 Krishna 知觉就被唤醒。
The Krishna consciousness movement is giving everyone a chance to awaken this consciousness.
所以 Krishna 知觉运动给予每一个人这样的机会，去唤醒他们心中的 Krishna 知觉。
And this way they can become perfect in their life.
这样的话，他们的生命，每个人的生命就能达到完美。
Perfection means to remember Krishna constantly.
完美意味着一个人恒常的冥想 Krishna.
Perfection could be understood in different ways.
完美可以以不同的这个角度去理解。
People may think perfection means that I don't make any mistakes.
有的人认为完美意味着我不会犯任何错误。
But one may make mistakes and at the same time also be perfect.
但是呢，一个人即使做了一些错误，但是他仍然有可能达到完美。
He should be properly situated, trying to serve Krishna.
他应该处在一个恰当的位置去努力地服务 Krishna。
Just like if one is engaged in the service of Krishna, that is perfection.
就比方说，当一个人在从事于对 Krishna 的服务的时候，这就是完美。
If we're not serving Krishna, then we are serving Maya.
如果我们不服务 Krishna 的话，我们就会服务 Maya。
But somebody who is doing service for Krishna, he's on that perfect platform.
但是如果一个人在从事于对 Krishna 的服务的话，他就处在完美的层面。
Even though sometimes he may make sometimes mistakes.
即便是有的时候他会犯一点点错误
but he is, if he is acting under instruction trying to serve Krishna then he is perfect
但是呢他是在这样的训示当中去活动的他在努力地服务 Krishna 这就是完美
just like Srila Prabhupada was asked that you know does the spiritual master know everything
就是就像有的人问圣帕帕德一位灵性导师必须是无所不知的吗
What do you think? 我们问你们灵性导师所有知道吗
不是
Yeah, he doesn't know everything because he's not God
不是的，就是一位灵性导师不必要无所不知，因为他不是神。
Krishna knows everything.
Krishna 无所不知。
He's God.
因为 Krishna 是神。
But the spiritual master is not God.
但灵性导师不是神。
So how can he know everything?
那他怎么可能所有的事情都知道呢
Then is he perfect?
那难道就说他不完美吗？
No, he's perfect.
不是的，他是完美的。
He's perfect because he's preaching the message of Krishna consciousness.
他是完美的，因为呢，他在传播 Krishna 知觉的知识。
He's engaged fully in the service of Krishna.
他在完全的从事于对 Krishna 的服务。
Making propaganda by speaking the glories of Krishna to everyone.
他在向每一个人讲述 Krishna。以这样的方式去传播这个教导
That is perfection
这就是完美
You also can become, We also can become perfect
我们大家都可以变得完美
The more we are speaking The more we are making propaganda for Krishna
我们讲的越多我们就可以越多的为 Krishna 做这个传道的工作
We want everyone to come to the perfect platform.
我们希望每一个人都能达到完美的层面。
Every living entity is part and parcel of Krishna.
每一个生物体都是 Krishna 不可分割的碎片部分。
Krishna has already said in the 15th chapter.
Krishna 已经在第十五章当中讲到。
Mami vamsa jiva loke jiva bhuta sanatana.Sanatana means eternally. We're always a part of Krishna.
Sanatana 的意思是永恒的，我们永恒的都是 Krishna 的一部分。
But manasastani indriyani prakriti stani karshati. We're struggling with the material energy.
但是呢，我们却在与这个物质能量苦苦争斗。
Are you struggling?
Yes.
你们在挣扎吗？
Oh, Sita's struggling.
Okay.
Young lady, still at school, and she's struggling with the material energy. This
young
lady is still at school, and she's
struggling with the material energy.
What to speak of all of us? Right? We are all struggling. And why are we struggling?
我们为什么会挣扎呢
The problem is described in the 7th chapter of Bhagavad-gita.
这个问题在《国家梵歌》的第七章当中提到。
Krishna described, first of all, his external energy, the material energy.
Krishna 首先描述了他的外在能量，这个物质能量。
Right, there are eight elements.
earth, water, fire, air, ether, mind, intelligence, and false teachers.
这有物质能量有八种元素，土、水、火、空气、体态、心、自信、假我。
So Krishna said, "These are my separate material energy."
所以他说到，这些都是与我分离的物质的能量。
It's Krishna's energy.
他们都是 Krishna 的能量。
It all belongs to Krishna.
都属于 Krishna.
Right? This temple.It's Krishna's temple.
这个庙宇是 Krishna 的庙宇。
Everything here belongs to Krishna.
这里所有的一切都属于 Krishna.
So why are we struggling with the material energy?
那我们为什么要和物质能量争斗呢？
Krishna goes on in the next verse, in the seventh chapter. He says, Apariyamitastvanyam prakritim vidimeparam.Jiva Bhuta Mahabaho Yeidam Jayate Jagat. Krishna is saying that besides this material energy, there is another energy, another prakriti.
Krishna 在《佛教梵歌》第七章下一个世界当中说到，除了这个物质能量之外，还有另外一种能量，另外一种 prakriti.
We are that other prakriti.
我们是属于另外那一种 prakriti.
There is the apara prakriti and the para prakriti.
这有 apara prakriti 和 para prakriti.
Two kinds. Prakriti meaning material energy.
这个有两种不同的能量，一种是物质能量。
So the living entity, all of us, we are in that prakriti.
另一种呢是灵性的能量，我们这些所有的生物体呢都是属于这种灵性的能量。
We are the superior, the higher prakriti.
我们是属于这种更高等的能量，灵性的能量。
We can take the elements of the material world and we can use them to do things, construct buildings.
我们就可以运用这些物质的能量，把这用这些物质的这些材料用来建造这些建筑。
Right? We have control. We have consciousness. The other prakriti does not have consciousness.
我们都有知觉，而低等的能量呢是不具有知觉的。
Right? This chair, this floor does not have consciousness.
这把椅子，这个地板，它们都是没有知觉的。
So we have consciousness. We can, if we want, we can build these things and we can destroy them also.
但是我们是具有知觉的，我们可以建造这些东西，也可以去摧毁这些东西。
What's the problem? Why is there any problem?
那为什么会有问题产生呢？
Because Krishna, because we are trying to exploit the material energy.
因为呢，我们想要去剥削物质能量。
Do you like to be exploited?
你们喜欢被剥削吗？
喜欢。
Have you got any experience you've been exploited?
你们大家有谁有这样的经历被别人剥削过？
Oh, you're not fair to me. You exploit me. Take unfair advantage of me.
你在剥削我，你在利用我。
So we don't like being exploited.
我们不喜欢被剥削。
But we are exploiting the material energy.
但我们却在剥削物质能量。
That's why, prakriti stani karshati. That's why we are struggling with the prakriti.
这就是我们在和物质能量苦苦争斗的原因所在。
Because we are trying to exploit, the material energy for our sense gratification.
这就是因为呢，我们在试图剥削物质能量来满足自己的感官。为了自己的感官享乐。
We have to recognize Krishna is the proprietor.
我们应该知道 Krishna 才是自身的拥有者。
We are entitled to some amount of enjoyment, but not more, not too much.
我们应该有一点点的感官享乐，但是呢，这个感官享乐是有一定的限度的，而不是过多的。
Krishna says, or it's described in the Ishopanishad.
在 Ishopanishad 当中说到
that everything belongs to the Supreme Lord.
他是万物，所有的一切都属于至尊主。
We should take what we need and don't take more.
我们应该接受我们需要的那一部分，而不应该就是获取更多的。
If we take more, then that is stealing.
如果我们获取更多了，那就好比是偷窃。
And that brings problems for us.
这就会给我们带来问题。
Krishna has his agents everywhere, his representatives are everywhere.
Krishna 有他的代理，在每一个地方呢都有他的代表。
He sees everything.
他能够看到一切。
He knows everything.
他也知晓一切。
About everyone.
他知晓每一个人的所有的事情。
We may think nobody knows.
我们也许会想，哦，我的事情没人会知道。
But Krishna knows.
但是 Krishna 会知道。
And Krishna brings reactions.
Krishna 会给我们带来相应的反应。
When we act the proper way, Krishna rewards.
当我们以恰当的方式去活动的话 ，Krishna 就会奖励我们。
Just like it's mentioned here, Krishna delivers.Devotee from birth and death.
就比如说在这个诗节里 Krishna 说到他会拯救奉献者让他们免于生死轮回
And when we don't surrender, when we try to exploit, we try to cheat Krishna, then we stay in the material world.
但如果我们不向 Krishna 皈依的话我们试图去剥削物质能量的话去欺骗 Krishna 的话那我们就只能够留在物质世界里
We're forced to take birth again.
我们会被迫再次的投生。
We can be put into demonic species of life, birth after birth.
我们可能会一世复一世的被投入在低等的种族当中。
Just like every night we hear the jackals. There's many jackals. You can hear them in the night.
就比方说在这里每天晚上我们可以听到豺狼的叫声、
right? Why have they got that body?
这些生物体为什么会得到这样的躯体呢
This is the misuse of their independence
就是因为他们误用了他们的独立性
They're put into the demonic species of life
所以他们被投入在这种具有恶魔本性的这个生命种族当中
You know, these jackals, they only eat in the night.
这些豺狼他们只在晚上吃东西。
You know that there's a story, the young boy died one day. He had gone to the forest with the family, but somehow the young boy died when they were in the forest.
有一个故事讲到，就是有一个年轻的男孩，他和他的家人们一起去了森林，但是不知什么原因呢，这个男孩在森林里死掉了。
So the family they were thinking what to do with the body.
然后他的家人就在想，把这个男孩的躯体该怎么办
？So just at that time, a vulture came.
就在那个时候呢，来了一头秃鹰。
Right? Have you seen these big vultures?
你们有没有见过这个大的那个秃鹰
？No, they eat dead bodies.
他们吃的是尸体。
But they can only eat in the daytime. The vulture can only eat in the daytime. They cannot eat at night.
这些秃鹰的话，他们只在白天进食，他们不会在晚上吃东西。
So the vulture came and began to speak to the people and told the people, "Oh, yes, it's very sad. This young man died. He was such a good boy."
这些秃鹰来就跟那些人说话，就说这个。男孩死掉了，他本来是一个很好的人。
And the vulture told the people that, you know, I think you should all go away and come back tomorrow, and you can do the, you should go away and discuss the glories, the wonderful good qualities of this boy, and come back tomorrow and do the burn his body tomorrow.
然后这些秃鹰就对那些人就说到呢，你们应该首先去荣耀一下这个男孩所具有的美好品质。然后呢，明天再过来，把这个男孩的躯体焚烧。
Because the vulture was hoping that if they would go, then he could eat the body.
因为这个秃鹫是这样想的， 就是这个男孩的家人一旦离开呢，他就把这个男孩的尸体吃掉。
But then the jackal came.
然后呢，来了一头豺狼。
And the jackal told them, "Yes, he's very sad. This young boy died. He was so nice boy."
然后这个豺狼就说到呢，哦，就是多么令人悲伤啊！这个男孩那么好的男孩死掉了。
Yes.But you don't have to worry, the soul's left the body, there's no more soul in the body, it's the soul which is the real person.
但是呢，你们不用担心，这个，因为呢，这个灵魂是离开了。
So you don't have to do any ceremony, you don't have to do any rituals for this body, just leave the body.
所以说呢，你们不需要为这个躯体做什么事情，你们把这个躯体，留在这里就可以了。
No, the jackal was hoping that soon it will be night and I can eat the body.
这个豺狼就是这样想的，如果他们把这个尸体留在这里的话，他晚上就可以吃。
So both the jackal and the vulture, they were speaking philosophy.
所以这个秃鹰呢和这些豺狼呢都在讲述哲学。
But they were speaking philosophy for their own sense gratification.
但是呢，他们是为了自己的感官享乐去讲述的。
They were not speaking philosophy for a higher purpose.
他们并不是为了更高的目的去讲述哲学。
So even the demons, even demonic species, they also speak philosophy.
所以说呢，甚至是那些恶魔，那些具有恶魔本性的人，他们也在讲述哲学。
But they are speaking it for sense gratification.
但是他们的讲述呢，是为了感官享乐。
Devotee speaks the philosophy of Krishna consciousness for awakening.The higher goal of life.
复现者讲述 Krishna 知觉的哲学，是为了唤醒更高的生命目标。
To get us out of this material world.
是为了让我们从这个物质世界里走出去。
To get us free from the material energy.
是为了让我们免于物质能量的影响。
Krishna, he spoke Bhagavad Gita.For this purpose.
所以说 Krishna 是为了这个目的讲述了薄伽梵歌。
We should try to understand.
我们应该试着去理解。
The more we chant Hare Krishna, the more we hear this knowledge from the scriptures, then the more our spiritual consciousness is awakened.
我们越多的去聆听 Krishna, 我们越多的去聆听这个哲学，我们。
The more the knowledge is awakened.
我们的这个知识呢，就越多的被唤醒。
The knowledge is all within us.
这门知识呢，本身已在我们的心中。
But we have to revive it. We have to awaken it.
但是呢，我们要去唤醒它。
By hearing and chant.
是通过聆听和唱诵去唤醒它。
And the more we hear and chant.The more we are developing our consciousness.
我们越多的聆听和唱诵，我们就能够越多的发展Krishna知觉。
So very powerful to hear and chant in the holy town of Mayapur.
在圣地 Mayapur 去聆听和唱诵是非常有力量的。
It's good everywhere, but it's especially powerful in the holy place like Mayapur.
聆听和唱诵在每一个地方呢都是有好处的，但是尤其在圣地，比如说像麦普这样的圣地，在这样的地方去聆听和唱诵会尤其的有力量。
It is said Lord Chaitanya in this holy place of Mayapur he does not take any offense.
在这个主查坦亚的这个圣地，所以麦普他并不会看待任何的冒犯。
In Vrindavan, it's more serious.
在 Vrindavan 会更严重一些。
If we make some mistake, we do some offense, we get more reaction.
如果我们在那里犯一些错误的话，如果我们在那边做一些冒犯的话，会得到很严厉的这个反应。
But here in Mayapur, Lord Chaitanya is very merciful.
但是呢，在 Mayapur 这里，主查坦亚非常的仁慈。
He sees what service you're doing, and he gives more and more benefit.
他只看一个人所从事的服务，给予他越来越多的好处。
谁，这边讲座里面打电话。
Okay, any question?
那这样有没有什么问题？